Prison's Log, Stardate 3142.8. We returned to the Devron system. Time was restored, as far as we know. Now we return to the nearest starbase for repairs. However, something has caught our attention. Something worth exploring.
Captain, we're picking up a strange distress call from a strange ship.
What can you tell us about it, Uhura?
Uncertain, sir. Its dialect is unlike anything I've ever heard. It's definitely not from this time.
Looks like an old ship. A DY-100, if I'm correct. They were designed on Earth in the late 1990s during an uncertain time of rebellion and upheaval. This vessel is called the Botany Bay. I can find no record of this particular vessel, though. I am still searching. Botany Bay? That was a penal colony on the shores of Australia, wasn't it? No doubt where the name is from. According to our databanks, the ship was built in a government base called Area 51, using sections from a Ferengi vessel that crashed to Roswell in 1947. During the rebellion, a band of criminals used the ship to escape the Earth. A band of unknown super soldiers that were part of a genetic experiment at the very same base. The Eugenics War. I vaguely remember. I propose we beam to the ship and see what we're dealing with. The ship's a historian. What's her name? McGiggins? McIvers. Right. She comes too.
Oh my god. These cryo chips look like they were from the latter end of the 20th century.
I thought cryogenics began in the late 21st century. My god, man, did you study at all at the Academy? Were you banging Orion women the entire time? History was never my forte, Doctor.
The ice seems to be melting. I think our presence may have activated the ship's computers.
Only one of the troops is numbered. Why? Maybe he's the leader.
That actually makes sense. We need to get one of these open.
Bones! Come check this out. Jim, this one's going into shock.
This one must have been programmed to wake up first. We have to get him out.
Could be contaminated. Jim, if we don't get this man out right now, he is going to die. Understood. Okay, get him out and beam him directly to sickbay. I am not joking.
How's the patient?
Interesting. It's like his body is fighting to stay alive. He must have the strength of 5 men at the rate he's improving. He could lift you and me with 1 arm. Has he said anything?
Not yet. I'd like to give him another hour or so before I give him a stimulant.
I want answers, Bones. Jim, we don't have to rush. The patient isn't going anywhere.
How? Ow. How?
How long?
2 centuries at least. How are you feeling?
I feel better.
My name is Captain James T. Kirk of the Starship Enterprise. We removed you from your ship, the Botany Bay. It was drifting in the Devron system. You were frozen. What's your name?
My crew.
They are sleeping. But we have them safe.
You will revive them, Captain.
Not until you provide us with some answers, starting with your name.
Khan.
Khan. That's your name. Just Khan.
Khan.
Why were you on that ship?
Forgive me. But you ask many questions, and I grow weary, Captain.
If you don't mind, I'd like to see records of the years I have missed.
So I'll have Lieutenant MacGyver set that up for you.
damn it! Spock, you have to be so damn creepy!
I apologize, Captain. I trust you slept well.
No! I didn't sleep well. I had a nightmare. You want to talk about that?
Khan Noonien Singh. One of your world's greatest tyrants. A ruler and warrior hailing from northern India, who led his army of rogues and rebels on a crusade to conquer the Earth's leaders. He fled.
Why?
It is possible, Captain, that Khan Noonien Singh and his men were overthrown and forced to escape in order to spare their lives. He was afraid. It is possible. The 1990s was a period of war, terrorism, and the military's war against it. It is possible Khan fled with his soldiers with the intention of preserving a future, as opposed to fighting a war they were losing in the present. But I am only speculating. We need facts, Captain. And I have none. I saw the guy who's better at understanding. I do not expect she will be Captain.
I really don't think you're gonna like living in our time.
You speak as though you are so sure of yourself. But when I look around, you know what I see? I see potential.
I've never known a man like you.
Who's seen and done so many...
Oh God, I sound like an idiot.
No, you're a very beautiful woman. You should grow your hair.
Mr. Khan, we are hardly here to talk about my hair.
I grew tired of talking about myself, my ship. I want to know something about you. You are very interesting to me, and it has been a long time since I have seen a woman.
Oh, I don't think you want to know anything about me.
Why not? Tell me, what is a beautiful woman like you doing in a place like this? Hmm? You all look miserable. Let your head down. Relax.
And exactly where would you like me to be?
Where? By my side. I would give you the world.
I don't know.
Well, get out then. Go. Come back when you do know.
Maybe I want to stay.
Then stay, but do it because it is what you wish to do.
What will we do?
We would take over this ship.
You can't ask me to help you do that. Why am I even talking about this?
Fine. I will find another woman.
No. I'll help you. I will do anything you ask.